Hi, my name is Pirut Moriban Buripan from Mahidol Vidyanathan School. Today I will present you my project about the personal and writing identity analysis algorithm, or I will call in short PHIA. So the objectives are to develop an algorithm for personal online and written character recognition and to develop the program from it. So the expected benefit is maybe this library could be for other developers. So let's begin on our algorithm. Now the data format and structures are to be a sequence of lines like this. And the overall structure is one user can have many profiles. The profiles contains many signs. For example, A, B, C, D, E, something like that. And each profile may represent different language, or you may refer to different type of writing or whatever. Now, after we got the input with each sequence of points, we sample each point from equal distances. And we normalize them by position and we scale them into the normalized size. After that, we came to the learning process or the training process. In the training process, we got many steps. At the first steps, each of the points, which is from the input and from the databases, are compared. For example, the first point of the input and the first point of the database are compared. The errors or the features we analyze are the distance between points, or the area between the angle, or the volume formed by the 3D shape formed by the strokes. And then we sum up. We make a total product of these errors by plusing each value by one, and we product it together. And for the signal that have many strokes in them, we plus each other and we find the weighted sum, and we got the score for it. The system will analyze whether if we have that symbol already. If we don't have that symbol already, or that symbol is absent in the database, we will cut it. We will add it into the database immediately without any consideration. But if not, we will consider that if the input character being the rivals with the old databases, we will add it because it must be a useful information to learn. So we define that the rival relationship between nodes is when the glyphs have zero likelihood. Otherwise, we will call them friends. Now, the next one is when we recognize this character, we use the defined relationship, rivals and friends, to help it out. In this process, we call it the filtering process. At first, we traverse to the or iterate to the first node which has the most rivals in the database, and we compare the input with the node, and we got the score. If the input node is friends with the node, it will give the rivals of them zero score immediately. And after that, we iterate into the next node, okay? And the process continues until all the nodes got the score and it ends the process. Then we sort the rest nodes in order of scores, and we got the one that has the most score as the most possible character as the result. So this is the overview of the project. For results, the memory usage, we found that the more the database learns the character, the less chance that it needs to learn more. And the time used is when recognizing is much less than the normal process because we use greedy reward assumption that we cut some nodes without processing. And the accuracy improves as we inform the correct answer after it fails to recognize. So let's test the program. Now, this is the folder. We've designed that the program should be portable. So if we run the install file, the shortcut will appear on the desktop and we can enter it. Now the window will appear and then after that we can use it. For example, in text editors or something, that the program will insert the possible character into the corresponding program. See, the letter A is now input into other program. And also, we can change into the other profiles. See, this is my language Thai. This is Gokai. This is Kokai. But then we see that it misses. So in order to edit the answer, we can change and tell the program what is the right answer, and the program learns the best answer possible. So the user have some flexibility to add their profiles freely. See, then plus the profile. Now the test profile now appears into the choice box. And then after we write something in the train mode, the database is shown and we can click to overview what it have learned. So in conclusion, we hope that this algorithm will improve the flexibility of the database to be more personal and to be generalized, that we don't have to fix the number of characters possible to learn. And now is the end of my presentation. Thank you.